Y'all remember Danielle Bregoli?
And all these hoes laughing like so funny. She's talking about the audience that they're laughing at her.
Did you say the hoes are laughing?
Yep.
So the audience are a bunch of hoes.
Yep.
Outside.
Yep, that's what we're gonna be talking about today. But what is going on today, YouTube? It's your boy CP, and today we're back for a brand new video. Today we're going to be talking about Scott Jackson and Danielle Bregoli's beef or feud or whatever's going on. See, I recently did kind of reaction to the Logan Paul Antonio Brown beef, and yeah, I figured I'd just do something. I want to just do more stuff. So I basically want to make this a discussion. First, I really don't know what started this, because a few days ago, Danielle Bregoli, aka Bad Baby, went on IG Live and she was talking about, she tried to say that Scott Jackson thought that she liked somebody or whatever it was. It was honestly, like, I'm just beyond under you guys. Honestly, it was a stupid reason. But in my opinion, I think only reason why this is hitting the media and not a whole lot of people are talking about it, but it's just something that's like out there. I think it's because both of them kind of want the attention, or at least I know Danielle Bregoli kind of wants the attention. I say that because even though she's a rapper, quote unquote, but she's kind of like faded, because back in like 2016, 2017, when she went on Dr. Phil, like there's so many memes about her, everybody knew who she was, this and the third. But now it's like barely anybody talks about her, if they do still talk about her. Like, yeah, now and then you'll see like a meme or something like that. But honestly, like, I even forgot that she existed for like I don't even want to say a year, a little less than a year, because I hadn't heard anything about her from her. Like, I just heard that she started rapping. I was like, bro, like, what, why? But I'm gonna show you guys the Instagram live video real quick. Granted, it's going to be profanity in it. I know I try to keep it family friendly, but she doesn't believe in family friendly.
Bitch is a big fan. Bitch, you're a huge fan. You're a whole fan. Like,
what's wrong with her being a fan?
Cause it's so she's moving sneaky, bro. Don't go post about me on your fake page, bitch. If you got something to say about me, post it on your page. Show me you fucking bold. The fuck? Show me you fucking bold.
Does she block you?
Bro, the bitch got me blocked on Instagram, blocked on Twitter, all type of shit. Like, bitch, grow up. That shit don't sit right with me. That shit don't sit right with me at all. I don't like that shit. Like, you don't even know if I'm talking to dude or not. You just seen us on Shade Room, so now you want to go fucking run and go like his pictures. Bitch, I'll kill you. I'll really kill you. Like, the fuck wrong with you, dumbass hoe? Like, come on. See him on the page talking about, oh, he's so fine, hook me up with him, he's so fine. Bitch, you are lame as fuck. You are lame. Before y'all start thinking I'm be tripping about young boy, it ain't even about young boy, because I don't care about what that man do. I don't care about what he got going on. That was old when she did that. That was the first person she did that with. But now she thinks she want to play. Bitch, bitch, you don't even know what I would do to you. You don't even know what the fuck I would do to you. So stop fucking trying to play with me. And let me find out you, and don't ever come to Glam House, bitch. You want to beat me so bad and get your nails done by the people that I got to get my nails done with? Bitch, don't ever come here, bitch, because I will kill you.
Come on outside.
I will kill you. But I don't care if you getting your nails done. I don't care what the fuck going on. I will walk up in this bitch and dog you. And you know my best friend going to let me know you in here. You dumbass dog ass hoes.
So yeah, Bad Baby's kind of tripping, if you ask me. Talking about she's gonna kill her, like, they're like, she's kind of taking it too far over nothing. See, I think what it is, I think Danielle Bregoli just wants to prove that she's like, oh, I'm the toughest person out here, this and the third. Like, there's no need for all that. Like, honestly, just you making your music, she doing her thing. Like, I don't even know why y'all beefing. Like, I really don't understand why anybody really beefs. Like, especially celebrities, like, y'all both making millions of dollars. So, like, why are y'all beefing? Honestly, like I said, it's probably just for publicity for one of or both of them. I think it's more so towards Danielle, only because she was starting to become irrelevant, quote unquote. But yeah, because I remember first seeing that video of her on Dr. Phil, I was like, bro, she's just saying, because I could not stop laughing. I was like, she's just saying anything, talking about Cash Me Outside, how about that? I was like, all right. But now she's talking about, like, oh, you don't know what I'll do to you, this, that, and the third. I'm like, yo, like, you really can't. Like, I don't care how street, hood, whatever you want to call it. I don't care how badass you think you are. Like, honestly, like, you can't be saying that type of stuff on Instagram Live, because, like, you could get in some serious trouble. Like, I'm just being real. Like, but honestly, like, what I think Scott Jackson should do, she should just let her talk. Because honestly, it's 2020. Like, if y'all are still really arguing over Instagram Live and stuff like that, like, what's the point? Like, if y'all not going to fight, which, let's be real, neither one of them is going to fight. Because we already saw what happened when Bad Baby and Vol Vicky got into it. They didn't even really do much. I think one of them threw a punch and the other one threw a punch, and then that was it. Like, come on now. I honestly don't think she's about half the stuff that she says. So, she, like I said, she's just putting on this charade just so, like, again, I don't know the full story. I don't know Danielle Bregoli personally. This is just my opinion. But I honestly think, like, she's just doing the most for what? Just for some clout? Or, like, come on now. Be realistic. Because honestly, I feel like if she keeps trying to do this, like, eventually somebody's going to catch her bluff, and then, like, she's going to be like, oh, y'all think I was joking, and then she's going to try to do something stupid, and then get even more publicity, and then basically somebody's going to, like, call her out on it, like, yo, I know you're bluffing, and eventually, like, they're going to be like, all right, then square up, and then, like I said, she's not going to be about it. Because, like I said, when she tried to mix Woe Vicky, for like, what's crazy is they both had security guards. So this is, I'm talking about the whole Woe Vicky and Danielle Bregoli thing. I don't know why they was beefing, but what's crazy is when they finally met in public, neither one of them wanted to swing first. And what was crazy is they was both saying, oh, I'll knock her out, this, that, and the third. Like, all right. And, like, we're all waiting for them to start throwing punches. Neither one of them did anything until they started getting broken up by security. And what ended up happening was Danielle, she, like, ran up behind her and kind of snuck Woe Vicky. I was like, bruh. And, like, what's crazy is she did one of them weak, like, she came around and went like this and tried to hit her. Oh my god, I'm gonna show you guys a clip of it real quick, because honestly, that thing was funny. Yeah, Fat Baby, she would just be doing the most. Like I said, it's all just for clout. And at the end of the day, that's all what it's about. Like, she's just trying to become more famous than what she already is. And she's just trying to keep herself from becoming irrelevant. So, my advice to Scott Jackson, just let this run its course. People will be talking about it, and then eventually, like, it'll just be nothing at all. And it'll be old news, and nobody will remember it in, like, less than a month. Bad Baby is just, like I said, she just talks. I mean, she want to talk or something. I'm not saying, oh, she's all talk, like, she's not about, because, granted, that's what I think. I'm not saying she definitely is, but that's just my opinion. I think she's all talk, because she really doesn't do much. All she does is, her rapping ain't even that good, to be honest. That's just my, see, I say my opinion. I'm not saying you guys have to agree with me. You can disagree. You're more than welcome to. But I'm just saying, like, in my opinion, her rap songs aren't even all that. So, like I said, she's just doing this for clout at the end of the day. Like, she really going, I feel like at some point she's just going to try to start beef with somebody else. Because, like I said, she started with Woe Vicky, and for some reason Lil Tay got involved. I don't know why. Lil Tay is like 9 years old, so I don't know why she's trying to get involved with them. First of all, I'm pretty sure Danielle's like 16, 17. Woe Vicky's just, I think she recently turned 18 or 19. And then it's like, you got this 9-year-old girl, like, what are you doing? But like I said, if I was Scott Jackson, I would just be like, all right, let it talk, let her get her out of the system, and then just move on to the next person who she wants to annoy. Because in my opinion, it's just ridiculous for you to, over something minor, and it's like, what's crazy is she tried to say like, every female keeps doing this every time they see me in the shade room with their man, they get like, they want to apprehend. I'm like, all right, well, if this has happened to you before and it keeps happening, then you shouldn't be fazed by it. Like, you should just be like, it happens, like, whatever, like, just move on. But instead, like, since it was Scott Jackson, she was like, all right, well, I'm gonna have to say something because you're famous or whatever. Like, and she started just talking about, oh, don't you have like a whole commercial or a movie or whatever. I'm like, I mean, granted, she's still doing TV shows, movies, and all that, and she was in the music video for Panini by Lil Nas X. So, you know that girl's getting money, regardless. So, whatever you want to say, like I said, they're both getting paid. So, at the end of the day, does any of this really matter? But, that was just my input on it. But I want to thank you guys for watching the video. Comment below. Which team are you repping? Team Scott Jackson or Team Bad Baby? Me? I'm team. I really don't have a side. Because it's like, I think this is all just for publicity. Like, it's just going to blow over. They're not going to fight. It's not going to be no lawsuit, or no matter what the media try to say, they're not going to do it. Because it's pointless. Like, you're just wasting each other's time. But make sure you leave a like, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
Well, I guess what's good for you is I made you just like how Oprah made you. You were nothing before I came on this show. Real shit, pussy niggas on that guilt trip. It'll be on in a heartbeat. You can hit on pussy niggas, shit skip. I fear God, never fear men. Give back, never give in. Be eyes, never be women. Keep an open mind, let them peek in it. Reach highs, never reach limits. Need minds, I don't need plenty. This C5, this for B.I. and left eye and T-Bys. When I seen Chili at a floor fight, I almost asked to the creek with me. But I was young and I held my tongue. But with that tongue, I just keep spitting, so it all worked out.